I welcome all of you here in this webinar. In this webinar, we are going to discuss very important issues, which is discussing everywhere in the government circle, in the teachers, among parents, and different section of the society. And that important issue is, number one, the reopening of a school. You know that since 22nd March, all schools is being closed down, and children are at the home, and they are facing so many issues, so many problems, trauma, pain, and even hunger, and so many problems they are facing. So now when lockdown is going to be open, the discussion is started around the reopening of schools. Number one, we are going to discuss these issues. Second is the fee of the private schools. That is also a very debatable issue. And third is the online education. You know that every conversation inside the government, in other webinars also, so people are talking about the online. Or online is a big thing now. Most of the business companies, education business companies, they are engaged with this debate, and they are bringing their own model of online. Even I am getting surprised that NCERT is signing a memorandum of understanding with the Rotary Club. Rotary Club is nothing to do with education. We never heard that Rotary Club is doing some education issue, taking education issue. Now they have signed a memorandum of understanding with the NCERT, and they are going to prepare curriculum for the online education. So these are the issues that are coming out. Or aap jante hain ki we have access, only 30% access of online digital facilities and online facilities in the country, and the most of the 70% children belonging to marginalized and deprived communities, they have no even mobile smartphones in their hands. Children are not having that smartphones. Even laptop computer is in the rural areas only 4% is available. So these are these major issues we are going to discuss in this webinar: the reopening of school fee issue, and third is the online. This big, creating a big digital divide, going to create a big digital divide. So these questions we are going to discuss here. और आप जानते हैं कि ये लॉकडाउन जो था उसमें बहुत सारा, और यहाँ इस वेबिनार में पीपल आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग फ्रॉम नॉर्थ ईस्ट, फ्रॉम सदर्न पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री, नॉर्थ इंडिया. So we will use English, Hindi both. It will be in bilingual, because some southern participants, they are requesting me that be careful about the language, so that they can participate and they can hear the voices of our panelists. So एक तो दो बातें मुझे सिर्फ कहनी है शुरू में. एक तो ये कि आप सब अपने, जो लोग नहीं बोलेंगे वो लोग अपने वीडियो और माइक ऑफ कर लेंगे, ताकि कोई नॉइज क्रिएट ना हो, और हम सब जो है इसको फुली एंजॉय कर सके. दूसरी बात जो मैं कहना चाहता हूं कि अब ये लॉकडाउन धीरे धीरे खुलने लगा है, एंड एवरीवेयर पीपल आर कमिंग इन देयर ऑफिसेज, एंड दे आर ऑन द रोड, एंड एवरीवेयर they are moving around. तो अब ये केसेज भी लेकिन बढ़ते चले जा रहे हैं, बहुत सारे केसेज बढ़ते चले जा रहे हैं, और अहमदाबाद से पटना तक और नॉर्थ ईस्ट से कर्नाटका तक जहां देखे वहां पे एक हाहाकार जैसी स्थिति है. बिकॉज और हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज, आवर प्रिपरेशन फॉर द प्रोवाइडिंग द हेल्थ फैसिलिटी टू द सिटीजन्स, दैट इज प्रूविंग वेरी पुअर. यू नो लोगों को इलाज नहीं मिल रहा है, बेड नहीं मिल रहा है. दिल्ली में तो हालत ये है कि प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स, दे आर सेलिंग देयर बेड्स, और पैसे मांगे जा रहे हैं. तो इस तरह की हालत हो गई है और बहुत ही दुर्भाग्य है कि हमारी सरकारें भी, राज्य और केंद्र की सरकारें भी, उन्होंने जनता को उनके अपने हाल पे छोड़ दिया है और वो जैसे चाहे वैसे रहे, इस तरह की सिचुएशन बनती चली जा रही है। और ऐसे समय में हमारे स्कूल ओपन करने की बहस चल रही है, एग्जामिनेशन की बहस चल रही है। मैं धन्यवाद साउथ इंडिया के कुछ राज्यों का जिन्होंने बच्चों को प्रमोट कर दिया और उन्होंने एग्जामिनेशन रद्द कर दिए। केरला और तमिलनाडु और कर्नाटक, तेलंगाना, इन तीन राज्यों का मैं उल्लेख करूंगा जिन्होंने अपने एग्जामिनेशन जो है वो खत्म कर दिए और बच्चों को प्रमोट कर दिया नेक्स्ट क्लास में। जो हमारी शुरू से ये मांग रही है, केंद्र सरकार से ये मांग रही है कि ये आप काम करिए, इस समय की स्थिति में बच्चे जो है वो एग्जामिनेशन देने के मूड में नहीं है, माने मेंटल हालत में नहीं है। तो ये सब बातें हैं। तो ये मैं कहना चाहता हूँ कि जब केसेज बढ़ रहे हैं, हमारी हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज बहुत ही एक्सपोज हो रही है धीरे धीरे और हालत बहुत खराब है, ऐसे समय में हमारे सरकारों ने लोगों को उनके अपने हाल पर छोड़ दिया है और संकट को अवसर में बदलने के लिए इवन चुनाव की तैयारियां में वो उतर गए हैं। और आप जानते हैं कि चुनाव की तैयारी में कुछ राज्यों के चुनाव होने वाले हैं, तो चुनाव की तैयारियों में उतर गए। बिहार जैसे राज्य में जहां के मजदूर वापस लौटे भूखे प्यासे, सैकड़ों किलोमीटर चल के उनको अपने जिलों में, अपने राज्य में वापस लौटना पड़ा है, उनके खाने का इंतजाम हम नहीं कर पाए, उनके वापस लाने का इंतजाम हम नहीं कर पाए, उनके बच्चे दोपहर की सड़क पर, जलती हुई सड़क पर पैदल चले। लेकिन हमने जो पहली चुनावी रैली देखी बिहार में, वर्चुअल रैली, उसमें 100 करोड़ रुपए खर्च हो गए, खर्च कर दिए गए। तो इस तरह की स्थिति है हमारे देश के अंदर। तो इसलिए हम समझते हैं कि आज इस पूरे माहौल में, इस परिवेश में हम इन तीन महत्वपूर्ण प्रश्नों पर चर्चा करते जा रहे हैं और हमारे बीच चर्चा करने वाले बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण लोग हैं। हमने पिछले बार बहुत सारे वेबिनार में हमने बहुत सारे विचार हमारे शिक्षाविदों के सुने, एक्टिविस्ट के सुने, अभी हम राज्यों की भी तो तस्वीर है उसको भी हम जानने की कोशिश करेंगे और क्या हो रहा है उन राज्यों में। तो हमारे बीच में अशोक अग्रवाल जी का परिचय देने की जरूरत नहीं है, पूरा देश उनको जानता है। गरीब बच्चों की शिक्षा हो या गरीब बच्चों की जिंदगी बचाने का सवाल हो, वो हमेशा अग्रिम मोर्चे पर रहे हैं और बहुत सारे फैसले हाई कोर्ट के जरिए भी उन्होंने गरीबों के हक में कराए हैं। तो वो है हमारे पैनलिस्ट, वो उनका मैं बहुत बहुत स्वागत करता हूँ यहाँ इस वेबिनार में। दूसरे हमारे प्रवीर बासु जी हैं जो वेस्ट बंगाल आरटी फोरम के कन्वीनर हैं और एक लंबा अनुभव है सामाजिक आंदोलनों का उनको, और एक लंबे समय से चाइल्ड लेबर के इशू पे भी और शिक्षा के मुद्दे पर वो काम करते आ रहे हैं, न केवल राज्य बंगाल में, दूसरे राज्यों में भी और बहुत सारे राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर भी उन्होंने सीएसीएल का की अध्यक्षता की है। और तीसरे हमारे जो पैनलिस्ट हैं वो अनिल प्रधान जी हैं। अनिल प्रधान जी उड़ीसा में एक मशहूर एक्टिविस्ट हैं, एक प्रसिद्ध एक्टिविस्ट हैं, सरकार की विभिन्न कमेटियों के भी में भी वो रहे हैं, बहुत सारे पॉलिसी मैटर्स पे भी उनका बड़ा पावरफुल इंटरव्यू है। उड़ीसा के आरटी फोरम के वो अध्यक्ष कन्वीनर है और ये हमारे जो बंगाल और उड़ीसा का आरटी फोरम है, ये सैकड़ों जो सामाजिक संगठन है, जन आंदोलन है, उनका एक कोलिशन है और उस कोलिशन के ये हमारे दो कन्वीनर आपके बीच में अपनी बात रखेंगे। और अशोक अग्रवाल जी, एक रिनाउंड शख्सियत इस देश की, वो अपनी बात रखेंगे और इस पूरी बहस को मॉडरेट करने के लिए, और मुझे खुशी है कि उन्होंने हमारे अनुरोध को स्वीकार किया, गीता वर्मा जो केयर इंडिया में गर्ल्स प्रोग्राम देखती हैं, उसकी हेड है और जिनका एक लंबा अनुभव रहा है शिक्षा के मुद्दे पर काम करने का, गर्ल्स एजुकेशन के मुद्दे पर काम करने का। और डॉक्टर गीता वर्मा है, वो पीएचडी भी है जवाहरलाल नेहरू यूनिवर्सिटी से। तो हमने उनको अनुरोध किया कि वो केयर भी हमारे आरटी फोरम का एक हिस्सा है, तो उन्होंने हमारा ये अनुरोध स्वीकार किया, उनका भी मैं स्वागत करता हूँ। और मैं ये चाहता हूँ कि अब आप इस गीता वर्मा जी से अनुरोध करूंगा कि वो इस वेबिनार की पैनल डिस्कशन की शुरुआत करें। और आप सबसे ये अनुरोध है कि ये वक्ताओं को सुनने के बाद आप अपने सवाल चैट बॉक्स में लिख दें, और चैट बॉक्स में जो आप सवाल लिखेंगे उन सवालों को फिर हमारी मॉडरेटर इन वक्ताओं के साथ जिनसे सवाल होगा उनसे पूछेंगी, और अगर जनरल सवाल होगा तो फिर उस पर वो बहस चलाएंगे। वक्ताओं की इस उनके वक्तव्य के बाद एक 15 से 20 मिनट हम लोग क्वेश्चन आंसर का ये सेशन रखेंगे। तो इसी के साथ आप सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत। हमारे बीच में वासंती जी तमिलनाडु से दिखाई दे रही हैं, हमारे बीच में शांता सिन्हा जी दिखाई दे रही हैं, और बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिनका मैं नाम नहीं ले पा रहा हूं। तो वो बहुत ही डिस्टिंग्विश ऑडियंस हमारे साथ है, तो मैं चाहूंगा कि अब इसकी शुरुआत हो। एंड 263 पार्टिसिपेंट भी हैं, अभी और लोग भी ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं, तो मैं गीता जी से अनुरोध करूंगा कि प्लीज अब आप शुरुआत करें। ओवर टू यू।
थैंक यू अम्बरीश भाई फॉर गिविंग अ वेरी गुड ओवरव्यू ऑफ द वेबिनार। आई थिंक एज यू हैव ऑलरेडी मेंशन्ड, we are going to talk about very pertinent issues today, which is about school reopening, school fees, and digital education. And in fact, you have already set a context why we are talking about these three issues and what is the relevance of these in our context. Just to add to what Amrish Bhai have said, basically, if we have looked at right now, there are about 65 countries globally who have decided to open their school, and they are thinking of opening a school in a very partial or a blended manner. One of the country is Britain, where they are going to allow only critical classes, for example, grade 8 or grade 10th, that are going to the next academic season. And also they are looking at a blended approach. So there are about 32 countries that are thinking that this year is going to be online education, while 100 countries have decided not to open their school till the time they have any such cases. So given the global scenario and the way India is thinking, I think we all also need to think about reopening of school in a more comprehensive manner. I think many of you may have read brief from a UN Secretary General where he mentioned that if a school have to open, they have to be a better school, they have to be a safer school, and they have to be a healthier school if at all they are going to open. I think this gives a very sound understanding to us, and also to a very good message to all the national governments how they need to look at their schools if they're going to talk about reopening. I think many of you may have also heard that very recently HRD minister said that we are not going to open a school before 15th of August. So I think these are some of the reality we are facing, and as Amrish Bhai said, we are planning to do today, we will take these three questions. One is a school reopening, and second is of a fee, especially in context of private school, and third is a digital education, online education. And as Amrish Bhai was saying, ki hame state mein kya chal raha hai, sarkar ki kya tayari hai, parents ka kya anubhav hai, और बच्चों को क्या महसूस हो रहा है, इन सभी पे हमें थोड़ी गहरी समझ चाहिए है। और जो मेरे पैनलिस्ट हैं, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट देम टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन देयर स्टेट स्पेसिफिक एक्सपीरियंसेस एंड देयर ओन अंडरस्टैंडिंग। विद दिस वी विल गिव वन क्वेश्चन टू पैनलिस्ट टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन, एंड आई थिंक ईच पैनलिस्ट विल हैव अबाउट 5 to 7 मिनट्स, एंड आफ्टर दैट वी विल मूव ऑन टू द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन एंड देन द थर्ड क्वेश्चन लाइकवाइज। एंड वंस वी हैव हर्ड ऑल थ्री पैनलिस्ट, देन वी विल हैव अ ओपन डिस्कशन फॉर अबाउट 10 to 15 मिनट। इज इट ओके अम्बरीश भाई? So with this, I would like to open the discussion, and I would request all three panelists, Ashok Ji, Anil Bhai, and Praveer Ji, to reflect on what are the approaches and strategies has been adopted or are in planning by the state government as they are planning to reopen their school. And as for their understanding, our parents are also ready to send their children to school at this point of a time. And if at all, if schools have to be reopened in coming months, what kind of a preparation is needed both by the parents and state governments to make school better, safer and healthier places? So I would like each panelist to spend about 5 to 7 minutes on these three questions and share their reflection. I would
continue. I will just give you an understanding about the state. How our state actually are grappling with different kind of problems, especially West Bengal restarting most economic activities in non-containment, yani ki green zones areas, on 8th June Monday. Authorities are concerned about the recent surge in case of deaths. The state has reported 400 plus cases for 4 straight days now. It is increasing very vigorously. The poorer states are yet to be seriously hit by the COVID-19 crisis. The moving map of COVID-19 cases in India clearly shows that the virus is now spreading to the eastern region from other parts of the country. This is more so when almost 6 to 7 lakh migrant workers are back home and few lakh more are really stranded in different parts of the country waiting for getting back to home. The state is under a twin crisis of COVID-19 pandemic and lockdown situation, plus it faces a huge financial, infrastructural and administrative crisis. About 1 million workers are getting back toiling and already facing severe crisis. Many of them already died on their way back. There has been very cruel accidents in between. Situation truly gets out of hand when the super cyclone Amphan has created havoc and devastated the agrarian population of the state. And now politics, which Amrish Bhaiji also was mentioning, politics has now come into play. It's quite early, but keeping the eye on 2021 assembly election, Amit Shah ji yesterday, he actually had a virtual rally and spent a huge lot of money. When this is happening, all this is happening, when the state is really succumbing to several wounds, the state is already suffering from different kind of agendas and now the election issue. Now coming to the agenda, on the reflection of the state's performance and position in education and learning during COVID-19 situation, I would first mention the secondary and higher secondary councils strangled over declaring the examination results on time and starting the next academic schedule due to the COVID-19 situation. The West Bengal Council of Higher Secondary Education and the postponement of the examination of the higher secondary, besides a few papers of class 11 annual examination also conducted by it. The West Bengal Board of Secondary Education is now notified to publish the result. In the meantime, at a meeting with HRD, several state governments flagged concerns over the digital divide in education to discuss about the way forward for learning amid the COVID-19 outbreak. While almost 7,000 of the 14,000 secondary and higher secondary schools in the state is now being treated as a quarantine center, and in view of these extraordinary circumstances due to COVID-19 pandemic and nationwide lockdown, some our state governments have already issued directive to the schools regarding promotion of all students from class 1 to 8. The minister said the government has asked all state-run, state-aided schools to enforce no detention policy from classes 1 to 8 this year. Now, coming back to the issue of reopening in the schools, West Bengal State Education Department has actually confirmed that schools and colleges in the state will remain closed until 30th June in the light of increasing COVID-19 cases. The decision to extend closure of educational institutions was announced by the state as they are being used as quarantine center for migrant workers. In Bengal, few schools have started demonstrating sessions for students and parents and teaching staff before its reopening. The schools will be asked to follow an alternate model, and department and the education department will ensure that classes take place adhering to the social distancing norms. Asked to elaborate on the alternate model, the education minister said that the detailed information will be notified subsequently. He added that state administration would ask private educational institutions also to follow the same timetable. Education minister also added that about the ongoing preparation of holding the pending board exams for new subjects. West Bengal, few subjects. West Bengal government plans to hold exams for pending subjects on the last week of June and the first week of July as part of the preparation for upcoming West Bengal board exams 2020. The state government will keep safety and health measures as top priority. So that's what the but they will also have confirmed that the new seating matrix, staggered classes, different mess and library rules, revamped hostels and canteens could be the part of students' socially distanced lives in the schools and colleges where they will return. Now, about the private school fees, I come to the next point. Our
Praveen, see, hum pehle, first we'll have okay. a discussion on a first question, then we'll move to the second part.
Okay.
I think what you have really mentioned about the schools are still closed in West Bengal and they are treated as a quarantine center. And I think this also flags another issue. Even if we reopen the school, what is going to happen in terms of sanitization and the safety measures? I think that's a very relevant point I have mentioned. Now, so Ashokji, first we focus on the school reopening and then we'll go on to other
issues. That's good. So what I want to submit that as far as the opening of the schools are concerned, my view based on schools should not be opened this year. It need to be declared as a zero academic year, and all students of all classes should be promoted. And जो सारे देश के पेरेंट्स है ना उन मेजोरिटी ऑफकोर्स एक्सेप्शन आर ऑलवेज देयर बट द मेजोरिटीज व्यू इज दैट दे आर नॉट मतलब दे कांट ट्रस्ट द गवर्नमेंट सिस्टम दैट देयर चिल्ड्रन विल बी प्रोटेक्टेड एंड the number of cases of they don't want to send and they don't want to give a chance to see that any casualty takes place, any bad things happen. So ultimately my submission is that this need to be declared as a zero academic year. And I think that there is no difficulty in promoting all the students, because in 1966, when I was studying in class 9 in a Delhi one government aided school, and at that time the teachers went on strike for 2-3 months, and then Delhi government was headed by as a chief executive. Government decided that voted from class 9 to 10, and I was happy also. So I think if it happens, our parents as well as the children will be happy. All will be happy, and therefore, and ये जो सोचते हैं लोग कि उसका academic year खराब हो गया और उसका जो भविष्य खराब हो गया, career खराब हो गया, ये सब fallacious thinking है. Let the children enjoy. क्या हुआ एक साल अगर एजुकेशन नहीं हुआ तो लेट देम चिल्ड्रन एंजॉय एट होम फॉर द ईयर एंड ऑल शुड बी प्रमोटेड दिस इज व्हाट आई माय व्यू इज एंड दिस इज This is supported by almost all over parents all over the country.
Thank you, Ashokji, for sharing your reflection. So, Ashokji, do we also have any understanding of how Delhi government is looking at a reopening of school, and what is your reflection on that?
Delhi government, I think they are under a lot of stress from the parents also that school should not be opened. But I think maybe I'm not sure about that private schools might be putting pressure on the government to reopen the school, because what is the latest news is that more than 80% of parents have not paid fees at all. So I don't know, but still my considered and firm view is that we should not go for any risk. We should not take a chance. And this year should be declared as a zero academic year. And all children should be promoted. Then all our parents as well as our children, students, all will be happy. No problem. No problem. And some countries are taking this view.
Yeah. Thank you, Ashokji, for sharing your view. We are grappling with the technology and, you know, how it actually is, you know, fails us at a critical time. And we can just imagine what is happening with children at this point of a time. So I will move to the next burning issue that we all have been talking and discussing about. I think given the interest of time, we have only half an hour for the discussion. So I will now move to the digital education. We all have witnessed state government has taken initiative for, you know, sending WhatsApp messages, and there is a eVidya portal, there is a Diksha portal, and there's a lot of e-learning apps have been infused by various civil society organizations and also by the state government. So I would like to understand both from a Praveeji and Anji and also Ashokji, what has been the situation in their state, and given that this experiment has been going on for about past 2 months, to what extent it has been enabled children to learn something from these digital tool? What has been the preparedness of a teacher and how comfortable they have been to engage with this tool? So it will be very important to have a field level insight, because what we have been hearing that is going to be a blended approach. Technology will become a very strong part of the new education school system. So it will be important to understand what are the barriers to these online platform or digital provisions we are talking about. What kind of operational nightmares are there, or at all, if it is a resilient education we are talking about? So these are the 2-3 key points I would like Ashokji and Praveen and Anilji to speak about. So can we start with Praveenji with your reflection from West Bengal on a digital education, state preparedness, and how parents and children are responding to this initiative? Praveenji? Do we have Praveerji? Shujita, I think Praveerji also not online.
He was there just now. I think maybe due to internet connectivity, he got disconnected.
Okay. So, and Anilji's phone is also not working?
Yes.
Anilji. Anilji, he is trying to log in through his phone. His laptop microphone wasn't working. So hopefully his phone will work.
So I think Ashokji se shuru kare. Ashokji, to is mera request rahega. Hum dono hi jo mudde hain us pe baat kar lete hain. Jo do mudde hain ki fee education ka aur digital education ka, kyunki connectivity problem ho raha hai.
Regarding online education, na. I think
so.
So, ye online education mein, as far as teachers are concerned, they are working very hard because they have a fear of losing job as well as their salaries. So, they are working very hard to convince students and impart education through online. But the point is that,
hello,
how many
hello,
are you hearing me?
Yes, please. Thank you.
Anil ji, थोड़ा वेट करेंगे, पहले अशोक जी से सुनते हैं, फिर आप ऑनलाइन रहेगा, इनके बाद आप आइएगा.
अभी कल मेरे से टेलीग्राफ के रिपोर्टर बात कर रहे थे, एंड दे वर टेलिंग मी दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज गोइंग टू टेक अ डिसीजन फॉर रिड्यूसिंग द सिलेबस बिकॉज क्लासेस आर नॉट टेकिंग प्लेस. तो ये इंटरमिक्स क्वेश्चन है अबाउट रिडक्शन ऑफ सिलेबस एंड द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस गोइंग ऑन. तो ऑनलाइन क्लासेस देखो, अभी तो बहुत सारे हमारे जो स्टूडेंट्स हैं, आर यू हियरिंग मी?
यस
बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स हैं, बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स हैं जो इकोनॉमिकली कैपेबल नहीं है और ये सारे जो इंस्ट्रूमेंट चाहिए इन सब चीजों को एक्सेस करने के लिए, देन दे आर नॉट फ्रेंडली दिस कंप्यूटर फ्रेंडली, दैट्स अनदर प्रॉब्लम. एंड थर्ड प्रॉब्लम इज दैट इन क्लास इन ए स्कूल ए स्टूडेंट रिमेन अबाउट 6-7 hours, और आप 5-6 hours अगर उसको उसके ऊपर क्लासेस देंगे और ही हैज टू स्टे विद द कंप्यूटर, तो बहुत सारे कंप्लेंट्स ये भी आ रही हैं कि लोगों की आई साइट इफेक्ट कर रही है, और दूसरा ये कि जो कम्युनिकेशन है, जैसे हम लोग ये बीच में बात कर रहे हैं और कितना कम्युनिकेशन डिस्टरबेंस हो रहा है, इसी तरीके से उसमें भी बहुत सारा कम्युनिकेशन डिस्टरबेंस होता है. तो मैनी टाइम्स जो है वो जो टीचर और स्टूडेंट के बीच में इंटरेक्शन ही नहीं हो पाता है. और तीसरी बात ये कि जो ये ऑनलाइन सिस्टम है, इट इज नॉट ए सब्स्टिट्यूट और क्लासेस. तो मेरा एक सबमिशन है ये पर्सनल ओपिनियन है कि इट शुड बी स्टॉप्ड ऑल टुगेदर बिकॉज इट हैज नो मीनिंग. और जो गवर्नमेंट ये सोच रही है कि बेस्ड ऑन कितने दिन क्लासेस हो रही है, क्या हो रहा है, उसके बेसिस के ऊपर आप जो यू आर गोइंग टू रिड्यूस द सिलेबस, दिस इज अनदर ब्लंडर द गवर्नमेंट इज गोइंग टू डू इट. एंड देयर डिसीजन वुड बी बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट? Talking with some teachers and talking with some students and some teachers and some parents. Can it be the base? The curriculums are decided by the expert body. Without going through that process, they are trying to take a short view, short way to take a decision. I think that is also not good. And still, we don't know when our school will reopen. How they can take a decision about cutting, adding or modifying the syllabus, I think that is also a very serious issue. The government must take advice from the experts before making any amendment in the curriculum. And second, let us wait for the school. So this is all useless exercise. It's through this online system must be stopped at all together, and let our children and parents must enjoy.
Thank you, Ashok ji. I think there are many questions that will be coming on this from the legal point of view, and we would want to hear what the legal implication could be on that. But I will move on to Anil bhai, who have been waiting for very long. Anil ji, I would request you to share your views both on a school opening and a digital education, and we would want to hear what is happening in Odisha.
Thank you, Mita ji. In Odisha, academic session ends in March. April is the time for new admission, evaluation of exam papers, and completing other formalities such as promotion, followed by summer vacation. Schools usually reopen on June 17. In the meantime, government has extended the summer vacation up to July in view of COVID-19. Government has supplied textbooks and worksheets to children during this lockdown period. It has also started online courses in only 3 coastal districts of Odisha through WhatsApp. Basically, government has instructed teachers to supply some materials as home tasks through WhatsApp and take follow-up action. I was inquiring about the progress of the program with some teachers. As per them, they are just sending worksheets developed by the government to students and inquiring with students whether they are facing any difficulties or not. But most of the cases children are not doing this assignment. First of all, about 30% children have Android mobile phones in these 3 districts. That too, in many cases, mobile phones are not generally used by their parents or uncle in their work site. Therefore, many children do not have access to the mobile site. Therefore, imparting online course is a failure program besides other pedagogical limitations. This is the situation in coastal belt of Orissa. Government has not done anything so far for other part of Orissa. Online courses are not suitable to Orissa because it is an underdeveloped state and many people do not have mobile sets. Besides, mobile connectivity is also an issue in Orissa. Wherever connectivity will be there, the success of online courses will depend on the ability of parents to guide their work. In view of the literacy situation in Orissa, it has no use. Regarding reopening of schools, government has declared that school will be closed until 30th of July. And in the first week of July, they will review the situation and take a decision. The biggest concern so far has been lack of transparency in decision making of government. No one knows what the government is planning to do. There is hardly any stakeholder consultation. Since online courses is not a viable option, government should go for online courses. Should not go for online courses. Government should try to reopen schools even if it is late. If government will reopen the school, it will face the following challenges. Number one, around 10,000 schools have been converted into temporary medical camps. It is quite unlikely this school building can return to their normal state. Because of spread of COVID-19 is expected to peak in July. Around 1,700 schools, residential school run by STSC Development Department, that also faces the similar challenges. Government may face difficulties in opening the residential school in the near future. Since more than 5 lakh migrant people have already returned and many people will be returning gradually to their native places, there is possibility of increasing number of school-going children in our village. In this situation, is our school system prepared to accommodate them? That is a big question. The situation of school infrastructure is not in a good shape. Government was also trying to close school having less enrollment. If decision will be implemented, more than 6,000 schools will be closed. The situation will be further complicated. However, the minister said that government will take admission of children in schools which we are supposed to close in view of low enrollment. Yes, there are infrastructure problems in Odisha, which are essential in the context of COVID-19. 15% schools do not have functional drinking water facilities. Around 10% of schools do not have functional toilet for boys. Similarly, around 7% schools do not have functional toilets for girls. Only 45.2% schools have wash facilities. And only 6.6% schools are complying with RT norms in Orissa. From the above data, one can imagine the challenges government is going to face for opening schools. This is about the situation in Orissa. Shall I talk about also private school?
I think aap Anil ji thoda private school ke bare mein bhi baat kariye, especially the fee ke bare mein, kyunki pata nahi connectivity fir baad mein kaisa ho jayega. और लोगों की रिक्वेस्ट है अनिल जी, एक और रिक्वेस्ट है कि आप अपना वीडियो अगर ओपन कर सके तो लोग आपको देख भी पाएंगे अगर कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं हो तो.
रिगार्डिंग वेविंग ऑफ फीस इन प्राइवेट स्कूल, आवर चीफ मिनिस्टर जस्ट मेड एन अपील टू प्राइवेट स्कूल टू वेव ऑफ फीस फॉर 3 months ड्यू टू COVID-19. दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेशर ऑफ पेरेंट्स एसोसिएशन. नो नोटिफिकेशन, nothing has been issued regarding this. No private school waiver fees so far as our knowledge is concerned. Parent association has filed a PIL in the High Court. Recently, government issued notice to start the process of admission. Parents association is opposing it, but I am confused regarding this decision by parent association. Since most of the private school survival depend upon fees they collect from parents, how do we expect that they will not collect fees from the student? If we are recognizing private school in our system, we cannot say that they will not collect fees. This is my personal view. Then I have a few suggestions. Shall I also?
Yes, Anil ji.
Then government should provide a financial package immediately to improve infrastructure facilities in school immediately. Government should form a committee consisting of members of civil society, education experts, representative of teachers union, and health expert, and start planning to reopen the schools. Online classes is not alternative to regular classes. Therefore, green zones should be identified by district administration and start reopening school as soon as possible. Eventually, yellow zones districts which may be turned into green zone in next few days or weeks should be allowed to open. Strict social distancing measures should be implemented and to limit the number of students classroom down in 2 hours to 2-4 hour shifts. A database should be kept for migrant children and Gandhi net would be issued for a specific school on a case-to-case basis to address the infrastructural issues. In case of red and orange zones, it might not be possible to open these schools anytime. Thus, there is a need to spend invest public funds to fill technological gap and ensure that students continue to learn. And however, children will suffer anyway in red zones and children of residential school. When life is threatened, we cannot say education should be provided compulsory to children. Government should scrap notification for closing schools because till date, government minister has only declared that admissions should be taken in school, but it has not declared that that circular should be scrapped. So I think it is high time that government should scrap that circular or merging the schools. Thank you.
Thank you, Anilji, for sharing the reality from the Odisha, one of the states that has a huge migrant children coming back to their home. And as you were rightly talking about, facilities not there for even having a healthy and proper school. Let's leave the digital devices aside. These are the hard reality. Thank you so much for sharing. Now we will move on to the West Bengal. We have a Praveerji with us. So Praveerji, can you share what is happening in West Bengal related to digital education? What are the steps and the reaction from the parents just around it?
Yeah, actually, regarding the digital education, our education minister recently told in a press conference that from now onward, there will be from class 9th standard to 12th standard, there will be online classes on TV sets and switch on the DD Bangla channel where in the classroom atmosphere will be there and some well-known teachers will give lecture on particular subjects. The students can also ask questions. The students can also ask questions during the classes through the phone numbers practically given during the show time, and also a mail ID is given. As the government wants to make it interactive, the minister said. Model questions for the activity report also can be downloaded. Now, in the meantime, in our state, we actually from CACL and RTE Forum together, we had conducted a rapid assessment on the status of child rights during the lockdown situation. And the major findings, which is yet to be finalized, of course, but a rough calculation shows, we actually collected responses from 2,093 children of across 15 districts in the state. 1,555 children attended schools regularly before lockdown, but during lockdown only 519, yani ki 33.37% of them getting to access the online education support. Platform like WhatsApp are being used by 73.4%, YouTube channel 5.4% children are using, telephone calls 29.4%, and online classes on TV channels for 15.9%. Reasons behind not receiving facilities of online education are, it is understandably evidently that no options of online education for 34% of the school going children. There are options, but 10% of children and their families are not aware. 30% school going children do not have access to smartphones or computer and obviously can't afford to internet access. 5.9% of these children were engaged in labor before lockdown, and during lockdown, 10.4% of such children continued in the labor sector. Average meal, food intake for the children per day during last week of May and also in the first week of June, 2% of the children had no meal practically. And then 1.8% of the children had one time, and 13.4% of the children could have two times meals. Families of 4.4% children are not receiving rations or foods from any sources, not even from schools and Anganwadi centers. Responses to these questions after responses to the questions like, after lockdown, when the school reopens, will the children turn up in the school? Then the responses were 1.6% told no, 6.5% were not sure. And it is quite evident from these above facts and figures, which is very small sample, of course. But however, we came to a conclusion that online education has impacted adversely to the secondary school students who are not getting to stay in connection with the digital platform due to less purchasing power. The students who enjoy this system are not happy due to technical difficulties that may cause the mental stress and expresses fear to stay enrolled in the school. There will be significant dropout and crisis can lead to a surge of child laborers, and the girl students who are deprived from online education can move to a surge in child marriage. So that's what our understanding is at the state level. Thank you. Yeah, Geeta, it's over to you. I have finished.
Yeah, thank you, Praveerji. I was unmuted by the host. So now we will move to the last, and I think in the chat box we have also received many questions related to this question about the school fee. And I think just I want to add 2 points to this so that a panelist can reflect on. One is that private schools are charging fee or asking for the fee when the schools are not open, and therefore they have started the online education so that there is some engagement with the children. But at the same time, what we have also been hearing that private schools have begun to cut the salary of the teachers and their staff, as well as many of the teachers have been sad. Well, they don't have money to support the teacher and staff. So in this situation, both from the teacher's point of view and also from the parents' point of view, understanding how it needs to be done and what is happening in your state vis-a-vis school fee, primarily with the private schools we are talking about. I would request Ashokji to share more on it. He has done a great work in Delhi. What are the way forward? How do we need to look at this issue?
देखिए, ये जो प्राइवेट स्कूल और फीस, ये तो फीस का इशू पहले से ही क्राइसिस में चल रहा है. लगभग 23 साल से ये इसका प्रॉब्लम बढ़ता ही जा रहा है, और अब जो है इस पेंडेमिक के अंदर, लॉकडाउन के अंदर, कोरोना क्राइसिस के अंदर, और भी ग्रेव, इट इज एंटर्ड इनटू ए ग्रेवेस्ट आई थिंक क्राइसिस नाउ व्हेन स्कूल्स आर नॉट फंक्शनिंग, और जो पेरेंट्स हैं उनका अर्निंग लेवल बहुत रिड्यूस हो गया है. ऑलमोस्ट मेनी पेरेंट्स डोंट हैव इवन मनी टू फीड देमसेल्व्स. दिस इज द सिचुएशन. एंड देन जो है कहाँ से फीस दे. और तीसरी प्रॉब्लम इसके अंदर जो है वो है फ्रॉम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ द स्कूल, जैसे ही कि उनका टीचर्स का, एम्प्लॉइज का सैलरी भी है. तो हमें एक तो सबसे पहले ये समझना चाहिए कि ये प्राइवेट स्कूल का जो प्रॉब्लम है, जो सिस्टम ग्रेवेस्ट हो गया है, दिस इज ऑल बिकॉज वी हैव लेट डाउन अवर गवर्नमेंट स्कूल सिस्टम. और इसीलिए जो गवर्नमेंट स्कूल सिस्टम है वही, मतलब वहां से ही प्रॉब्लम है और वही से आंसर है इसका. तो हमें ये आज फिर से समझना पड़ेगा कि क्या हमें गवर्नमेंट स्कूल सिस्टम को जो है इम्प्रूव करना चाहिए, और अगर नहीं करेंगे तो ये आने वाले वक्त में और भी क्राइसिस बढ़ सकते हैं. अभी सवाल ये है कि जो बजट स्कूल्स हैं, जो लगभग 80-85% जो है हिंदुस्तान में बजट स्कूल्स हैं, छोटे या 200 रुपए, 300 रुपए, 400 रुपए, 500 फीस ली जाती है, वो स्कूल की हालत तो बहुत ही खराब हो गई है. उसमें ऑलमोस्ट 80% तो स्कूल वालों ने एम्प्लॉइज ही निकाल दिए, टीचर्स ही निकाल दिए, और 80% पेरेंट्स ने उनको जो है फीस दी ही नहीं है। और इंटरेस्टिंग एस्पेक्ट, वन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग एस्पेक्ट है कि पेरेंट्स ने वॉलेंटरली अपने बच्चों को ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन से भी विड्रॉ कर लिया है, क्योंकि जब वो ऑनलाइन आएंगे तो टीचर बोलेगा फीस जमा करो, तो ऑनलाइन से भी विड्रॉ कर लिया है। तो ये डिपेंड क्राइसिस में चला गया है। और जहां तक जो बिगर स्कूल्स हैं, जो सो कॉल्ड बिग स्कूल्स हैं, वहां पर कुछ पेरेंट्स ने जमा कर दिया है, लेकिन मेजोरिटी जो है वो दे आर स्टिल अनेबल टू पे। इवन मिडिल क्लास, जो अपर थोड़ा मिडिल क्लास है, वो भी सफर कर रहा है, क्योंकि बहुत सारे लोगों का बिजनेस भी बैठ गया है। तो ऐसी स्थिति में जो है, व्हाट इज द सोल्यूशन? सोल्यूशन ये है कि अभी तो हम लोगों का कहना ये है कि कम से कम 3 महीने का फीस जो है वो तो आप बिल्कुल वेव ऑफ कर दो, 3 महीने का, अप्रैल मई जून, एंड लेट अस रिव्यू इट इन जुलाई क्या पोजीशन होता है। और हमारा कहना ये भी है कि जो मेजॉरिटी स्कूल्स हैं, जो बिग स्कूल्स हैं, उन्होंने पिछले 20 साल में इतना पैसा कमाया है कि अगर वो चाहे तो एक साल पूरे जो है एम्प्लॉइज को बिना फीस लिए हुए एम्प्लॉइज को अपनी सैलरी दे सकते हैं। तो वो लोग जो है वो इससे बचना चाह रहे हैं और ये प्रेशर क्रिएट करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि टीचर्स को सैलरी देना है। तो अभी राइट नाउ यही है कि 3 महीने का जो है वो वेव ऑफ होना चाहिए, नंबर एक। दूसरा ये कि कोई फीस इंक्रीज नहीं होनी चाहिए इस साल के अंदर, बिल्कुल टोटली नो इंक्रीज। एंड थर्ड ये है कि जब स्कूल खोलेंगे उस वक्त जो है, उस वक्त ये पेरेंट्स के साथ बैठकर डिसाइड करें कि फीस कैसे सेटल करनी है, क्योंकि अगर ये नहीं करेंगे तो बहुत सारे जो प्राइवेट स्कूल्स हैं वो मुझे लगता है कि वर्ज ऑफ क्लोजर है, क्लोज हो जाएंगे, और बहुत सारे पेरेंट्स जो है क्लोज नहीं भी होंगे तो बहुत सारे पेरेंट्स अपने बच्चों को विड्रॉ कर लेंगे। अब सवाल ये है कि पेरेंट फिर से फंस गया, पहले तो गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में ना जाके प्राइवेट में आया, अब प्राइवेट से मजबूरी में निकालेगा तो जाएगा कहाँ, है, और गवर्नमेंट स्कूल स्टिल नॉट फंक्शनिंग वेल। तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा क्राइसिस है, मुझे लगता है कि नेशनल लेवल पे हम लोगों को इसके ऊपर चर्चा करनी चाहिए, एंड वी शुड कम टू सम कंक्लूजन। थैंक यू। हेलो,
थैंक यू अशोक जी। कैन आई रिक्वेस्ट प्रवीर जी टू शेयर हिज रिफ्लेक्शन ऑन प्राइवेट स्कूल फी एंड व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन वेस्ट बंगाल ऑन दिस?
इट इज ऑलमोस्ट लाइक what Ashok ji has just now told, the situation is almost similar, especially when we see not entirely in West Bengal but only in Kolkata, where the big schools are there, big private schools, they are actually charging fees, even in spite of the fact that our minister, education minister and chief secretary, they have been repeatedly requesting the private schools take the fees, but to and waive the fees for the 3 months, as Ashok ji has said. This has been requested by the government only, but in spite of the fact, the guardians were pressurized to deposit the fees. Now the one unique thing has happened in the meantime here in our state. The guardians of the private schools, they have really mobilized themselves against this pressure, and they have been almost protesting every day, but now they have a platform like West Bengal Private Schools Guardians Forum, and they have opened a Facebook page also, and we see there are some many thousands of guardians, they are actually reflecting their views in the Facebook, and this is being so much, I mean this united action has been so sound and vigorous that Chief Minister also said that she is going to sit with his guardians very soon. So let's see what happens. But it's true that the big schools can really pay the fees to the teachers, even in spite of the fact that they cannot, if they don't take the fees from the students, they can easily manage to pay their teachers, but they are not doing that and they are pressurizing. And most importantly, now we see that the DPS school, they have actually started selling the mask also from the school, and those masks are branded. I mean, branded the school's emblem have been put into the mask, and they are selling it. So now it's really a kind of business we see in the education sector. So that's it. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Prabir ji. Anil, Pradhanji, can we have your view on a school fee and how the private schools are functioning in the state?
Actually, Agarwal ji and Prabir ji have already told about the situation. Here in Orissa, we have few big schools, few big private schools, but most of the schools are small private schools. If they will not, I think if they will not collect fees from the children, it will be difficult for them to manage the schools. So what will happen, I don't know, but private school association is getting stronger also, and they are fighting at the high court level, and the government is remain silent. And once our chief minister declared that, not declared, he appealed all the government private school that 3 months, so fees should not be collected for 3 months, but no guidelines and nothing, no instruction has been issued by the government. So they are not serious. Actually, government is not serious about this private schools, because as you know, most of our bureaucrats and the politicians, they send their children to private school only. That's why they have a soft corner for them. And this is about the situation in Odisha. But parents' association are demanding that there should not be fee, because school may not open in near future. That's why they will take admission of children, and why they will collect fees from right now. So that's why they are opposing for this admission issue. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Anilji. I think I wish to thank each of the panelists for share their reflection on these three critical issues. In the chat box, we have received a lot of reflections, and in fact, sort of aligning with what is mentioned. And there are also a few questions that have come up. So I will take only a few critical questions that have been shared by our participant to the panelists. I think you can decide which question you want to take, but I think they can be, each one of you can reflect on that. Ashok ji, one of the critical point has come in when you were talking about the budget school, you know, how they are going to run if they don't charge fees. So that is one question has come in, because it is also a livelihood for many of the people, and especially in a rural context. And what happens to the children who will not be part of a budget school when they are closed? So that is a one question people are asking. And other question is related to what you have been talking about, the zero academic year. What happens to the children if we declare the zero academic year? Do you see it's going to be a dropout and children engaging in a child labor and other activities? So these are the two critical issues have come from participants. I would request you to again reflect both from the legal part of it, and also how we can address as a group.
So I think what is in the interest of the child, we should see nothing else. We should not see anybody's interest except the children's interest. And the children's interest is that they should not be sent to school in such a bad situation when more and more corona cases are coming up. And governments have literally failed to handle them. And we know all over country, barring some south states, that what is the status of health services. So they should not be. Now the question is, merely because they are not going to school, will they become the child labor? No, I don't think. Merely because of the reason that children not going to school because schools are closed. अब हम लोग दो महीने की छुट्टी होती है, फिर 15-20 दिन की फिर छुट्टी होती है. तो यू वी शुड लेट अस टेक इट कि भाई बजाय 2 महीने की छुट्टी या 12 महीने की छुट्टी हो गई है. हाउ मेक्स ए डिफरेंस ऑफ दैट? So I don't think that merely because schools are closed, child labor will increase. I don't think child labor will increase in the context when lakhs and lakhs of poor migrant labor have migrated from cities to some other places, that will result. My estimate is that suppose schools are open, then in government schools there will be a reduction of enrollment from 30 to 35%. There is possibility of reduction because of this migration. And then at the same time in the private schools also there will be a reduction in enrollment from 5 to 10% for so many reasons, because many parents will not be able to afford fees also. That will be one of the reasons. And then migration also, there are certain children who have parents have been migrated along with the children, and they were studying in the private school, like EWS students. Many EWS students under Right to Education Act taking education in private schools, their parents have migrated along with the children. If they don't come back, there will be dropout. So this is one part. Second part is budget schools. Budget schools, we are always opposed to these budget schools, right from day one. So many NGOs are supporting it for whatever reason, I don't know. But we have been always opposing because they are not fulfilling the norms. Basic norms, they don't fulfill. 80-85% of the budget school don't fulfill the basic norms. Now, 2010 Act, now we are in 2020. They have not been able. They don't pay proper salaries to the staff. So these, according to me, all these budget school must be closed. Must be closed, and all children should be shifted to government system. Now again, question comes to that we have to improve the government system. There is no other choice as far as the, we have seen these private hospitals and public hospitals not functioning, private hospitals not responding to the problem, and what is happening? So we have no alternative in both areas, education and health. We have to strengthen our public education system. There is no other way at all. We have to think again, and all of us have to think again in the interest of children and the interest of nation. I think one more question, some. हेलो
आपकी आवाज अशोक जी थोड़ा ब्रेक हो रही है.
अब आ रही है?
हाँ हाँ अभी आ रही है.
हाँ हाँ तो मैं कह रहा हूँ कोई और क्वेश्चन है इसका?
जी सर, बस अभी यही क्वेश्चन है अशोक जी. आई थिंक थैंक यू सो मच. हम अगर कुछ आएगा आपसे फिर कनेक्ट करेंगे.
वेलकम वेलकम.
थैंक यू अनिल जी एंड प्रवीर जी. देयर आर टू थ्री क्वेश्चन दैट आर प्रोबब्ली यू कैन रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन. वन question has come, this is also a time to reflect on how do we integrate a digital education as part of a school education, because so far we have primarily depended on a face-to-face. So people have asked, don't you think this is also an opportunity to even train our teachers to use this kind of a tools for the future? And second question has come in, if the schools have to be reopened even after 3 and 4 months, in your view, what are the specific steps the state government needs to take, given that a large number of schools are a quarantine center? So these are the two big questions have come in. And third, which came in just now, that many of our higher education institutions have declared these two semesters as where no education will happen. Why can't a school can also decide in a similar way? So these are the three critical questions have come up from the participant. I would like you to reflect on that first, Anil ji, and then Praveer ji.
Actually, देखिए अभी जो उड़ीसा का सिचुएशन है, स्कूल बंद होगा, ज्यादा दिन बंद हो जाएगा, तो जरूर जो चिल्ड्रेन का ड्रॉप आउट हो जाएगा, उनका चाइल्ड लेबर हो जाएंगे, और जो वो सब सिचुएशन है, एंड इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज में वो शामिल हो जाएंगे, वही सिचुएशन है. तो इसलिए हमारा आरटी फ्रॉम तरफ से हमने गवर्नमेंट को भी सजेशन दिया था कि चिल्ड्रेन शुड बी एंगेज इन डिफरेंट वेज, इवन इफ इट इज नॉट थ्रू द रेगुलर स्कूल प्रोसेस, but they should be engaged. Otherwise, in Orissa, as you know, we have 23% people belongs to tribal communities or the children of tribal community and other backward communities will be engaged in this economic activities if they will be not engaged, and child marriage will be promoted, child labor will be promoted like that. That's why we suggested government that government should involve civil society organization and devise some mechanism so that the children, even if they are not coming to school, they will be engaged in a systematic manner. But we don't know what is happening at the government level. There is absolutely no transparency in the decision making. That is one thing. Then in Odisha, I have already told you that 10,000 schools have been converted into TMC, temporary medical camps. So, kya kara jayega? Wo pata nahi hai. Kya? Wo to abhi to pura khali nahi hoga. Kyunki abhi to jo Basu ji already told that coronavirus patients that infection is increasing in Odisha and West Bengal right now because this migrant population are returning to their home. So that is a big problem for Odisha. Then we have residential schools run by STC Development Department. That is also a problem because the residential school cannot be open right now in near future also. So government have to think, government has to consult different stakeholders to plan different things, but it is not responding. Then another issue is about this school closure and merger. If that school closure will happen, then more than 6,000 schools will be closed. Then most of the schools are in tribal area. So the tribal people will be mostly affected. And tribal and disabled and girls, they will be mostly affected. So government should actually organize consultation with teachers union, civil society organization and other experts and the medical department also. So these are my views.
Just to take
regarding
from
digital
here.
Education, actually, in Odisha, it is not possible. Okay. Because connectivity is a problem, and other things like availability of mobile phone, computer.
Sure. Thank you, Anilji. Praveerji, you wanted to say or add your view?
Exactly.
Yeah, please.
On the online education program, what I feel is that we should not be fully depending on the online education. This could be a supplementary or complementary kind of thing. But in the meantime, what we in our state from RT Forum, we have seen many teachers in the government teachers, they have solely on their own taken some very unique initiative in connecting the students even during the lockdown period. So there are many good practices, even some CSOs and NGOs, they are also doing the same thing. I mean, connecting with the students in actual life and trying to get in touch with the students physically, keeping this social distancing and other health matters in mind, they are doing that. So I think that should continue. That should continue more vigorously. Teachers should go out to reconnect the students. And they should really find out in our state, actually we are doing this survey, the assessment, rapid assessment, with the idea of having an idea that who are the children who are in red zone. Red means, from our point of view, red is dangerous. I mean, they have already decided that they will not turn up in the school once again. And then there are yellow zones, who the parents and the children both are confused. Whether they will continue in education or not, they don't understand. They are totally in confused state. And the green zone, they are better off. I think idea wise and the conceptually, they are quite better off. That once the school reopens, whenever it is, if it is after 6 months also, they might come back. So we want to really concentrate with the children in the yellow and the red zone, who are really becoming dangerous, and those who will definitely be dropping out once the school reopens. So one way of remedial measures we see that if we start connecting the students, those children, and taking the government teachers also along with us, and encouraging them to reach out to the community at in a community hall or somewhere where the physical distance can be maintained in rotation wise in different slots, they can really meet the different students in their of different classes at the community level. Also, they can bring few children to the school also. The schools which are not at all quarantine center, those which have not been converted into quarantine center now, because 50% of the schools are still free from that. So in those areas, the schools also can be used where fewer students can be called up in the schools itself, and they can be assisted with this understanding of the syllabus and coping up with the situation of this lockdown. So that's what we feel. But ongoing, this could be a very good opportunity for the teachers as well as the students, that online education or digital education, they will slowly and gradually, they will start coping up with this mechanism also. This should not be just written off.
Are already exceeded our time limit that we had set for ourselves, which was about 12:30. We are already in 12:49. But I think all the panelists have shared a very strong perspective and also the ground situation. So for benefits of everybody, I'll just summarize three and four critical points that have come up. I think one of the key recommendation or the reflection has been that the digital education and online education is actually not reaching out to all the children. Even if reaching out, this impact is not visible, and it's also leading to the stress and all the health problem that Ashokji was highlighting. I think this requires a serious reflection and engagement. If at all, as we move forward, I think what Prabirji has said, we need a blended approach to look at to what extent a digital education could be part of our school system. One point that have come in is that we need to declare this academic year as a zero academic year, and probably we can look at whether it should be done for the primary or secondary or higher secondary. But there is one strong suggestion from Ashokji, and many of the participants have given their consent to this recommendation. How do we, what happens to children? What do we do with that during the period? That is something to reflect on. Third, I think, which have also thrown something for all of us to think, is about the budget school getting closed because parents are not paying fee. And what happens to these children who will be leaving the budget school, but they're not part of a government school system. I think the last point, which is coming very strongly for all of you, is that our government really need to invest in school education, both for the infra, even if there is intent to promote a digital education, there has to be devices and instrument. I think this provision is started without any preparation at both government level and the teachers level. Teachers are even not prepared how to handle children when they are in online mode, what kind of handholding support needs to go. And the last point, which have been very pertinent, that so far government hasn't engaged neither parent or school management committees or other stakeholder. I think that has to be one of the biggest link, whether we are talking about reopening the school, whether we are talking about promotion of a digital education. It doesn't have a consent of parents or the school management committee that has been one of the local accountability authority as per the Right to Education Act. I think these are the broad key points our participant and the panelists have also shared. So with this, with the permission of Amrishji, I would like to close the webinar of today. And thank you so much for all the panelists for sharing the ground reality and what is happening in each of the state, and also your personal perspective and opinion how we need to address these three critical issues in context of India and a various state. Thank you so much, everybody.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद गीता जी आपको एक बढ़िया मॉडरेशन के लिए, और अशोक जी, प्रवीर जी और अनिल भाई आप सबको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, एंड एवरीबडी हु पार्टिसिपेटेड इन दिस वेबिनार आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक एवरीबडी। एक जो सबसे बड़ी बात जो समझ में आ रही है जिसके लिए हमें जरूर चिंता करने की जरूरत है वो ये है कि MHRD इज रेगुलरली इन कंसल्टेशन विद द private sector and most of the digital companies they are moving around the MHRD and they are suggesting everything to MHRD. They are not consulting with the teachers association, they are not consulting it, MHRD not consulting but with the renowned educationists in this country, and neither they are consulting the educationists nor they are consulting with the activists or most of the NGOs who are working in education sector. They are only consulting with the Rotary Club, with the MOOCs platform, like platform, the private sector, and this is threat for the public education system. And we are just we can assume that where we are going in the hand of the private sector, those who are making profit from the education, those who want education converted into the commodity. So that's the big danger posing. Big danger is we can look and we can assume in the future. So we have to come together to raise our voices with the teachers association also to defend our right to education, to defend public education system in this country. This is the need of our. Otherwise, we lose our. The education of 70%, more than 80% children who are belonging to marginalized and deprived classes. Thank you.